Hi guys, welcome to the August episode.
Which isn't July.
No, it isn't July apparently. And yeah, so I'll start off with, well, mainly Sega stuff today. So I've got my trip up to, a lot of stuff I picked up, FIFA International Soccer and NHL Hockey 94, which is a double pack, which never come out, isn't a double pack, so I've just condensed it into two. I have no interest in hockey, I've never played the NHL.
Really good.
Yeah.
Really good.
Mm. Played the FIFA. The FIFA is really good.
It's just Pittsburgh like Penguins.
It's a better sound and a lot worse loading.
The hockey I played was Wayne Gretzky, but it's exactly the same series.
Yeah.
Exactly the same series.
Yeah.
And FIFA's weird. I mean, when you consider like Madden and hockey and all the other series, they all had like a person.
Yeah, like a main person.
They always had a person, you know, whereas FIFA never did.
No. I mean, it's like now there's always the Lionel Messi on the cover, but back in them
days. No, but there's still no actual name.
That's David Platt. I know who that is.
Yeah. No actual name at the beginning of it. You know what I mean? Yeah.
Don't know who the guy in the red is. Does anybody know? But we know the guy in English at David Platt. He went to Sampdoria and he came back to England to Arsenal. Way too much watching football.
Yes.
Yes, and on trip to
don't do stuff.
Play Nation, I picked up Flink on the Mega CD as well.
By Sognosis?
Yeah.
Which is generally your sort of like sign that it's going to be a crappy Amiga port.
Yeah.
You know, yeah.
So it's a platform game. Not played it before. Rarity one. So. And going for the Dreamcast collection, as we know, I picked up a few more this month. Not as many as last month.
Thank God.
Yeah. I fucking played them in the end.
Yeah.
Sonic Shuffle, I needed one. Really cool party game in the vein of Mario, but with the world's longest loading time. I mean, every time you make a move in this game, it freaking loads. And it loads.
I don't think there's a single one of these board game things that's actually as good as playing a board game. To be honest. I mean, there are, you know, party games, there are brilliant party games, like Bomberman and stuff like that, they're brilliant to play.
Yeah.
I'm not even playing lots of people, blah blah blah.
Not his fucking nephews though.
Right. Because it kicks your ass.
Back in the day.
Yes,
20 years ago or something like that.
Yes.
And River Bazaar game, JoJo's Bizarre Adventure. I got this on the Dreamcast back in the day when it came out. I think this is a brilliant game. 2D fighter, very strange little, what do you call it? Little spin on it where you have like a
stand.
You, where you call your little standy person in and they do a certain move, and it's very strange. It's hard ones because this doesn't, it's hard ones that makes sense.
It doesn't play quite like any other 2D beat 'em up. It's really odd. I mean,
unique.
I have tried to get into it so hard and I can't. I just don't really like it. I really don't.
I played this again when they re-released it on Xbox Live. Was it about a year or two ago?
Yeah.
And I just forgot what a bizarre, strange game it was. And I really did enjoy it back in the day of playing it. But yeah, it was an era that I'm happy to have moved on from. One of the games that I remember going through slowly, finishing it with every character. But bloody difficult. Some characters, they just... The moves and everything.
It's very hard, even from the first fight, I think that game's hard. I think that game is hard from the first fight. If you haven't got a basic understanding of how everything works, it is just hard. Even on the easier setting, it's still hard.
Yeah. And then Noon Steel 1, Chronicles of Pern Dragon Riders. It's some action-adventure RPG. And where's the English translation? Yeah, so it's just an action adventure RPG and you ride a dragon. I know nothing about it, played it?
Nope.
No. So. Snowcross, racing on snow bikes.
Snowmobiles.
Yeah, so racing on snowmobiles. Land, snow racing game, played it last week, didn't we? And.
Shite.
Surf rocket races. This is basically wave race on the Dreamcast, yeah, but nowhere near as good. The water effects are quite nice, so we know exactly.
Go play Splashdown on Xbox or PS2. Much better.
Gauntlet Legends! Four player Gauntlet Legends with four new characters. Didn't you say that you can unlock characters?
There's loads of unlockable
stuff in there. Yeah.
Also, when you upgrade, like you upgrade from like warrior and you can become a minotaur.
Oh,
right. And cool. Stuff like that. Yeah. So, yeah, I think that's the one you can
do. So, more than a straight on spin on the actual traditional gauntlet looking style of the game.
I think that, I mean, this is the first Gauntlet Legends.
Yeah, I know.
What are you on about? Right,
a spin on the original Gauntlet style adventure.
It's basically very sort of Baldur's Gate-ish, you know, it's Baldur's Gate just for the
Yeah.
Well, it is on the consoles anyway.
Yeah. Army Men's Digest Heroes. I think back in the day they tried to bring back the green soldiers versus the brown soldiers.
Yeah.
The grey soldiers.
Well, after Toy Story, Toy Story,
yeah.
PS1, there was a blight of
those flooded
shit. It was a blight of those crappy, awful fucking Army Men games.
Yeah. Because people had them in their memory from the Toy Story film. Yeah. Oh, I want to play with soldiers. Yeah. Let's release games of soldiers in. Yeah, I mean, this one's got a 4-player split screen and Ducati World.
Motorbike game he can't play.
Well, I really can't fucking play. Super sensitive controls. I couldn't even go around corners probably, did I? But yes, motorbikes. I like cars. I like motorbikes. Did you play this game?
I didn't play it.
You didn't play it, no. What about when you sat here watching me play?
I wasn't watching you play, I was in the kitchen making food.
Yeah, there you go. And the highlight of the Dreamcast games is Resident Evil 3. Yeah, this is the one that I picked up from Regenerating Gaming in Norwich.
Awesome game.
My favourite of the Resident Evil series. Still my favourite. I mean,
stars!
For me, 2's the best, but 3's still good.
The tension of always having the nemesis chasing you, and just the absolute fear of when you hear that window smash and you see the nemesis and oh my god, I've got to get out of here!
Yeah,
you
but the biggest because, problem you know, is every single character you bump into, they're gonna die.
You just play through the mercenaries to unlock the guns.
Yeah,
like,
you've got to unlock the mercenaries. Yeah, and then Chris either uses action replay or play it properly and unlock like mini guns and shit like that.
No, you just have to. You do that on mercenary on that one. You just get these stronger guns so that you can run through. You know, when old Mr. Stars turns up, use your magnum, bang bang, dead.
Yeah. Now I always remember. So just when you're in the outside part, when you're weaving between the burning buses. And the nemesis, and you've got a little bit to run past them. I remember jumping, actually physically being, I'm going to die, I'm never going to get past this part. But yeah, and just some PC Engine bits. I've got a pretty good package off eBay, and I'm well happy we've got. I've got Sidearms, and I really like this game. I played it loads in the arcade back in the days in Deal Arcade, many, many moons ago.
I used to play that religiously. Cool.
Yeah, I played it again recently on the Capcom collection that came out for the 360. What was that called? That had this millions of games.
Yeah, we both played it.
That was really, really cool. And I really enjoyed it. I haven't got around to playing any of these yet, but I will do. This one I know nothing about. It's the only weak one in this package, and it's Final Lap Twin.
I played the arcade version.
Yeah,
and it's like Continental Circus. It was alright, the arcade version was okay, but the driving games don't transfer that well to the PC engine. Outrun and
I'm thinking of Super Sprint, and I the little
overview.
Yeah, top arcade. Just to spin it as you walked out or something like that. And Final Soldier, fantastic. This is part of these. Is it called the Soldier?
Star Soldier.
The Star Soldier. And once again, I haven't played this one yet, but I know it's one to play. It's quite a renowned series. That there's, is there three of them? Four of them. Yeah, and I know this is one I'm going to get. We've got the PC Engine former shooters, basically. I knew so many are out. Image Fight, a really cool game. Now, the story behind this is I really, really wanted to get the Saturn version because it had the Saturn version, Jenny Point in Japan's got X Multiply and Image Fight on it. So I really liked it. Proper hard game. Real, real hard game. But if you see the price of the Saturn version of it now, I mean, oh, for Christ's sake, £200 plus. But I say, in this package, we have this player. Not played the PC Engine version, don't actually know anything of the PC Engine version. You?
No. A bit of IREM goodness that isn't like R-Type, because everyone just associates R-Type with IREM and that's it. And they did do quite a few shooters.
Yeah, so. R-Type 2, R-Type 3.
In the Hunt.
Yeah, In the Hunt. Cubex Core, whatever. We can't quite figure it out. But yeah, we know it's a shooter because it's actually got a screenshot. Look, a PC Engine game with a screenshot. You don't
first
ever see that.
Ever.
It never happens. So yeah, looks like you fly a dragon in this one, and you fly what looks like a blue fart machine. I don't know.
What does a fart machine actually look like? Like why do you know what a
like
fart machine looks
firing
like?
Firing bubbles from all angles. But that certainly looks fun to play. So, and the last PC Engine game I picked up this month in the package is Dragon Spirit. And one to you.
Oh, you know what it is.
Yeah, it's a game that even got record footage of on the Wii.
It's a funky vertical shooter. It was on various Namco compilations and stuff.
Yeah.
Which is the best version to get it for.
Yeah.
It's not that great on the PC Engine, but it's pretty good. It's pretty good. It's still fun. It's still a good game. Not as good as the original.
Yeah,
they never are, but they're cool. Still really good though. Still really good. Cool. It's nice artwork and stuff.
So I really want to get around to playing with Skylanders Trap Team, but we have this sort of issue where you do actually need to be a millionaire to play it properly.
No, it's not that. You see, it's just even if you could find them, even if you just find them at retail price, you need to buy 7 more £15 Trap Masters. You then need at least 6 traps, which are £5 a piece, and then you need to buy the light and dark packs, which are about £25 to £30 a piece. Once you've got those, then you can play it properly. And that's not all the characters at all. There's a lot more characters than that.
But the mini characters.
There's loads of everything for it. But that is what you need to basically access most of the game.
The biggest disappointment we had with Trap Team is just the fact that our previous figures are just pretty much useless.
Yeah, yeah. They work. Mm. You can use them, but you can't open anything with them at all. And it was a bullshit decision. I mean, to have new areas that the newer characters could open, like they did in Swap Force, would be fine.
Mm.
That would have been fine. But the fact that you can't use the... It's pointless to use the old characters. Makes the whole game sour for me. I mean, I bought it on launch. I'll never buy another Skylanders game on launch. And it's just really frustrating. Because it is good. It is good. It's just really marred by this, you will give us your money thing. It's just not on.
And on the evidence of that, when I was up in Lowestoft, they were actually doing an offer on some of the figures. So I sort of like messaged him, saying, oh, what do I need? I went out and bought a couple anyway until I knew actually what I needed. I went out and bought this dude. He was on offer on the day for £8. So, you know, happy to pay that. And I bought these two because these were in the 2 for £20. I was kind of hoping that I could literally buy 3 or 4 more packs and that would be it. I could start playing it properly. But oh, I was very, very wrong. I was completely wrong, but yeah, so I'm sort of happy to get hold of that. On the Croydon visit as well, LGG had something for me, but he put by for me, and that was Super Buster Move on the Game Boy Advance.
It was hidden in his beard.
It was literally, I mean, you could easily hide that. I mean, you could pretty much hide this in his beard soon, because it's getting that big. But yeah, Buster Move on the Game Boy Advance. Well, I'd play it on the Game Boy Player, of course, on the GameCube, and soon I bought Buster Move on the GameCube recently, you know. Slightly different version of it. We wasn't umming and ahhing because, you know, there's lots and lots of fake Game Boy Advance games going around these days, and it's making everyone paranoid, especially me and Ali as well, about what's fake and what's new. So we've looked at it, and it all looks genuine to us, but we ain't no experts. We haven't got a clue what to look for when looking for fake games. So, just to get you paranoid as well. Destroy All Humans 2. This completes my need for the Destroy All Humans game. They're quite fun. I played the first
one. Destroy All Humans!
I played the first one for about 25 minutes. And I thought it seemed to be okay with mind control, take control of people. So you around playing them?
That's fun.
Yeah,
just a fun piss about, blow shit up. Take control of
they
people.
They kind of got worse as this went on because there was nowhere they could really go with it. So they just sort of changed time periods. I went from like 50s, the 60s, the 70s.
One trick pony, you keep giving a new hairstyle.
Yeah.
Project Zero 3. Yeah, really into actually trying to get around to playing this, especially with the release of the new Project Zero coming.
And spooky lightning to kind of accompany it. Yeah.
Now all we need is for the light to go out, and Chris has got the camera, so he's the one that can protect us. Yeah. Real proper horror, scary type game. So basically, you hunt around in like haunted houses and places like that, and the only way you can fight off the bad guys is by using your camera.
Very much based on the Japanese style of horror films, like The Grudge, Ringu, Deep Dark Water. Yes. All those sort of Japanese ones, which have generally been translated into pretty horrible English or American.
With Sarah Michelle Gellar.
That's The Grudge.
Yeah. But yeah, I mean, we've got like, we've got 1, 2, and 3 over here. We've got number 5 on the way, I think. Is it a number 5, proper number 5?
No. Is it 5? I think it is 5. I'm not sure.
Because number 4 only came out in Japan, which is really irritating.
But it is available as a translator patch. It is available as a translator patch.
Yeah, so there you go, you can get it. But I happened to do a little road trip for Jason recently so he could do some trades. He paid me via Ultimate Street Fighter 4. So this is fuel money.
Not huge beard, Jason.
Yeah. Because this has also been huge beard, Jason's beard.
Mm.
Yeah. So you're rank amateur compared to him.
Exactly.
You need to get going. You need to get going again. But yeah, this is about 5 new characters, 6 new characters for this.
Well, they're more rehashes.
Yeah.
Or it was basically ones that just ported over from
Tekken 8 Street Fighter. Whichever way around it was, because the other one's supposed to still be in development. And I quite like the Street Fighter 4 games. I don't like them enough to play online multiplayer. I like to have a bashing single player now and again. I lose on my multiplayer one.
It's one of those things I always like to get my game back on with those things, but yeah. It's just a little bit too complicated for my liking. It's good, but it's a little bit too deep. I mean, I like to have a game that's easy to get into, but has a lot of depth to it. Whereas that isn't really like that. It is, to be honest, fairly hard to get into.
Mm.
Not as hard to get into, I think, as Killer Instinct. But
I'm still trying, but I'm liking Killer Instinct. Yeah, Tekken Tag Tournament. We are Tekken Edition, which comes with a lovely art book, soundtrack, CD, and exclusive Team Games, apparently. Yeah, so I'll pick this one up. From Swallow Games in Norwich. And yeah, Tekken games are cool. Remind me for the tag one, so I always get tagged in 6 confused.
A tag, the biggest problem with tag is lack of content. I mean, there's loads of factors. There are absolutely loads. There's a relatively okay, just like a story mode thing, but that's it. There's no other real modes to it. There's not really any other modes to it. Whereas Tekken 6 has a lot of different variety and weird final fight style modes and a lot of content. That really doesn't. It's a fantastic game just to play with your friends and stuff like that, but it really lacks on the one player thing. Every single character does have an ending thing that does save, so there is a reason to play through the character. But
I've always liked the Tekken endings. That's been cool, because I liked it in the original series where you used to finish a character and you used to unlock another one, didn't you? Get an end character, and that character would always be related. The character unlocked would always be like, if you complete the king, you unlocked Armor King, which was just a different person.
Sometimes, though, that they were completely different characters.
Mm.
But they would be based on someone else. They would be based on someone else. Like, what was it? I can't remember who you had to beat it with to get Kuma, but it wasn't, didn't play like, you know, because Jack unlocks P-Jack.
Mm.
But you know, it's
prototype game, the one that just looks all more roboty. Yeah, Earl Grey. Yeah, it's onto some.
You say Earl Grey.
All Grey.
Oh.
If it's Earl Grey, that would be him, because he loves his Earl Grey, doesn't he, Mr. Kite want to be? William Shatner was the best. William Shatner is the best captain ever in Star Trek. No arguing. You can see the sly smile he's doing behind the camera.
I don't know what you're talking about.
My next game is going to be Infamous Second Son. My God!
Yeah. I can't get behind that!
Not anymore. I want to kiss Uhura, but I'm God. Right, yeah, so Infamous Second Son. I have got all of them now. So I've got the other one last month, first light. And new character in this one, as you can see from the trailer. Seems to be a cocky, arrogant little dude. But you're in
your... What happened to the first son? Did he die?
Quite possible. He is the second son.
He hasn't played the second game yet. No, played the first one. He hasn't played the second one.
So, I shall see. So, yes, the second son. It's lovely. Now, the PS4, the next PS4 game is my joint game of the month that I'm doing.
Yeah, so he's smoking a joint when he plays.
Yes, and that is Until Dawn. And holy fucking wow.
It looks amazing. I mean, it looks amazing. This game does make me kind of want to buy a PS4 to play.
It's a long last consequence game.
There's actually something I want to play exclusively on the PS4. At long last.
Yeah.
And that's this.
Basically, it's your horror game in the woods, and it's your horror game in the woods. It's your horror film in the woods. You got a bunch of delinquent teenagers, grown up people, whatever. They go camping.
He's covering all his bases here. There's basically a bunch of annoying, stereotypical American teenagers.
Much better way to put it. He's better.
Which you can basically manipulate and make choices for them. And those choices will basically, and you have to search for these totems. Those choices will basically determine whether they live or die. You'll get totems if you search every nook and cranny. There's little hints about how characters could die. And you have to look at those and just double guess and work out what you need to do. It's really.
You can get, I mean, basically, there's loads of different endings you can get through. You can finish this game with not everyone dead, but it's an ending.
Well, everyone alive.
Yeah, or everyone alive, or just a few people alive. And it follows the horror genre rules, like, get your tits out, gonna die. Offer to have sex with someone, you're gonna die. Say, I'll be right back, you're gonna die. So, yeah. Really, really looking forward to playing
it. Plays with those conventions. It plays with those conventions. You don't have to follow them. It kind of plays with them. It's quite clever. So,
but that is my number one to play. I mean, I'm so chuffed that there is an amazing game like that on the PS4, because there was, you know, the next game is Uncharted, which is next year, but at least there's a reason for me to turn the bloody thing on now. And on to the next game, Xbox One-y time, Battlefield Hardline. I'm actually,
Cops and Robbers.
Yeah, actually playing this game at the moment, and you know what? It's fucking brilliant. They're really cool. The driving sections are probably substandard.
They're quite fun.
Yeah, but they're a bit. They're so easy. You can not, you know, not turn a corner. When you turn a corner, I'm used to like.
I wasn't doing that. I was just looking around. I was like, you're driving along and you're like looking over there. It's like,
this is a first-person shooter where you can go in. You can stealth the guys up. You get a little badge. You can flash them first with your badge. And their reaction.
Freeze! Please!
Yeah, their reaction can be either I'm going to fucking shoot you, whoa, okay, and that way you handcuff them and you can get them off your wanted list. It's got your general collectible. Really good game, really, really enjoy it. Tough game I've been looking forward to playing for a little while. And my joint other game of the month, which is in fact 30 games of the month, which is Rare Replay. And yes, I got the version where you get a free t shirt. Yay, green t shirt! As opposed to green tea. Yeah, one of the games I played for the first time on here, I was talking to somebody about it, was RC Pro-Ham. I had never, ever played that in my life.
RC Pro-Ham? You kind of have this big ham hock, and you just kind of sit on it and you ride it. That'd be awesome.
Yeah, that'd be awesome.
There's a lot of people riding like roast chickens, you see, like in a piece of beef.
Yeah, you can get pinatas in there if you want to. Yeah, it's brilliant. It's one of the ones that I've never played before. To be honest, there's not many I have played on this. I've played Banjos, played Perfect Darks.
Well, you played the ones they brought out on 360.
Yeah, I was playing the 360 remakes and played a little bit of Blast Box when you had it. And it's pretty cool that all these are on there. And they're slowly getting around to like fixing controls, because apparently JetForce Gemini was unplayable.
Yeah.
But they've updated the control method now, which makes it playable.
The thing was, it was unplayable on the N64.
Yeah.
It was horrible. It was really, really
that
horrible.
That was where they used the analog and then used those five buttons. Little directional C buttons, weren't it, to try and make up another joypad, which another didn't game, really work.
I put RC Pro-Am on. It was the second game I played in this pack, and I really enjoyed it. The first game I played on this pack is the most furious, makes me want to kill everyone game in my life. And that is Battletoads on the NES.
And he was only playing the easy bit. He was only playing the first level, the easiest part of the whole game.
See, I played through Battletoads in the arcade, which isn't the arcade version of the original on this pack, which isn't too bad. I think it's quite good. The level's a bit overlong, but I enjoyed it. Obviously, very multiplayer. But that fucking thing they put on the NES, why? I mean, lining up your characters to just get your ass kicked and never knowing if they're actually going to die or not. The first level, it keeps going on like this jetpack level, but I shall probably never get around to getting that.
The turbo tunnel.
But yeah, so one of our local shops has found a nice box upstairs full of Master System games. He let me know, put out for sale, so I shot over there and picked them up. Got a really good price on this stuff, but there's lots. And so let's just get started. Predator 2. I really like the Mega Drive version. Top-down view. Retro City Rampage style again. Look at Danny Glover in the Predator, isn't
Fair enough.
That's quite a good game. I played it for a little bit on the Mega Drive, but it's the same as always. The problem with the Mega Drive was I found that I just kept running out of ammo, and it's just let's fight the street thugs before we get to find the Predator and just fight the Predator. And can you feel the love tonight in the Lion King?
Like the majority of Master System games, Mega Drive version's better.
Yeah,
I could probably sit here and say that I've probably got half of these games, but yeah, the Lion King's actually quite. If I remember rightly, it's really hard on my system.
Crazy hard.
If I remember rightly,
crazy hard. Yeah,
but, it's easier on the Mega Drive.
Dime Soldiers. I sort of like always thought this was a sort of Smash TV, you know, Merc style game. Yeah, you go out the screen. Biggest problem with this game is pad and the controls for it.
Use a joystick.
I don't have a Master System joystick. Do you want to give me one?
No, but I do.
Oh, there you go. I'll have it. Thank you very much.
Yeah, but it's a lefty, isn't it?
Yeah.
The joystick way around, isn't it? Lefty. Well, I can do that, though. I can do that. But, yeah. Sonic Chaos. I got this on the Game Gear, and I sort of enjoyed it, but the screen on the Game Gear does my head. I can get about 40 minutes in the game.
Firstly, it's zoomed in. It's not just the bad quality of the screen and the scrolling.
Yeah.
It's zoomed in as well, so you can't see where the fuck you're going.
So I actually get to play it on the Master System. I don't see this very often. I've seen it once or twice. But he's actually got like 9 copies of this up there. Where it is, we'll tell you soon. But yeah, so good Sonic game. I've never spent much time in it, though. Have you spent much time?
No.
Now, one thing we know is a dreadful game, and that is Operation Wolf.
But it works with the light gun.
Yeah, it works with the light gun. Remember, as long as you haven't got a flat screen telly.
And
as long as you haven't got, yes, a modern LCD, plasma, 4K,
LCD, LED,
MI5, FBI, type situation. Yeah, so you can use your light gun for this or control pad. Your Sega light phaser with the control pad as well. Really enjoyed this in the arcade. I remember sat in an arcade watching a bloke put literally 30 quid in this back in the day, trying to finish the last level, and he still couldn't. So why put 30 quid in it when you can just press start again on the pad?
Yeah, it was the Uzi that made that arcade game. Yeah, the fact that they had a bolted on Uzi was just awesome.
Your operation is finished.
And normally, when you go to these arcade games, the gun's smaller than it should be.
Yeah.
This Uzi was fucking huge. It was like the world's first 50 caliber Uzi. Yeah. It was just ginormous.
They shrunk it for Operation Thunder.
Thunderbolt,
yeah. So you have 2 players in there. But this one was massive.
Yeah.
And yeah, it was cool. And a couple of arcade ones from Sega. And that would be Golden Axe. Not a patch on the PlayStation 2 remake. Come out in Japan.
God, that's awful.
Oh, that is dreadful.
I mean, this is still bad, though. It's still pretty bad, but it's still better than that PS2 remake, which was awful. It's coming in the Sega Rages pack over here.
I mean, it's just absolutely hilarious awful. That it does that throwing animation, even though you just press the button by mistake and you can't stop it.
It's just fucking awful. The music's amazing, though. The music's amazing on PS2 version.
And on to the next one. That'll be a condition. Crazy, isn't it? Altered Beast. I have a confession to make. I've played this once, and I played this once on the Mega Drive pack. That was to get the achievement where you have to collect so many things to turn into the beast.
The arcade version is actually very good. The arcade version is actually good. But I never liked the Mega Drive version, and this version can kiss my ass.
Yeah, so it's going to be good. yes. American Baseball. Your pitcher stands ready on the mound. The batter snarls back. You wind up and hurl a fastball. Crack! Wood meets ball. The outfielder scramble. There's a play at the plate. He's safe!
Get Baseball Stars 2 on the Neo Geo or 2022 Baseball.
Yeah.
Ignore this.
Don't play this. Now, this one's going to be interesting to play in the Master System. That's Marvel Madness. So, yeah.
It wasn't too bad on the NES. It's still not a patch on the arcade version of the one.
No. Yeah, cool. Get your marbles from the top to the bottom without falling off the side or falling into cracks and holes and cracks and easy. So, and then to the next one, Line of Fire. Pretty much the same.
Which is nice because it actually has decent cover.
Yeah, yeah.
Which is nice, which is really rare for
not nice colory and not just the awful stuff. This is like a Mercs game, but as always, fucking one player, Sega control pad or control stick. So, yeah, I like the Commandos and Mercs game, but even Mercs on the Mega Drive, only one player, which is irritating. World Soccer.
We have got like 20 copies of that, haven't we?
No, because there's so many generic world football games that I checked and I was going to know. But, you know, so it's soccer in a world. You can dribble past and take corner kicks and retrieve your opponent's ball. Now, when we do footage, if it's me playing it, you'll see because I will concede a goal. I never tend to score. On to the next game, which in total shitty condition, but it works that I paid £3 for, so I was happy with. No manual and a really, really, really just badly fucked up back. And that's Alex Kidd in Tech World. Because talking to you about your one sort of bits, you can get it cheap enough, go and get it. I've played Shinobi and Miracle World, but I've never played this one. Have you played this one?
This one, yeah. It's good.
Alex Kidd.
If you like Alex Kidd, Alex Kidd is an acquired taste. It's not. It's quite different to all the other kind of platformer type games. It's like they never quite got it right. It always annoyed me that they showcased Alex Kidd over Wonder Boy because the Wonder Boy game is so much fucking better than the Alex Kidd ones. Especially Wonder Boy 3. So much better.
So you've got to get that the Dragon Trap. When we was at play recently, play Margate, there was two copies of it there, but even read manuals, and I got home and bought a manual that day. He said, no, it completes my copy now, it's not for sale. Won that game. But yeah, I've even got cheat codes if I want this, actually on the case. Ayrton Senna's Super Monaco Grand Prix 2.
No drive version's better.
Yeah. Oh, it's got an Ayrton Senna on the front, so it's got someone's name on it. Yeah. This is like the arcade Monaco's.
Probably the most famous racing car driver.
Of all time.
Of all time.
Didn't he die though?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, we
they're racing at the track this weekend where he died, or next weekend where he died.
All I seem to be hearing lately about racing is how people are dying, are being hit by tyres flying around the tracks and test tracks and stuff like that. So, great job. Go look elsewhere. So, Jurassic Park and the Sega Master System. This version of Jurassic Park, this version is very different to the one that came out on the Mega Drive because you don't run around with guns in this version. You are the dinosaurs.
You play as dinosaurs, didn't you?
No, Mega Drive version, you play as... Oh. It plays both there. You learn something new. Because I remember in this one, you go around as Sam O'Neill's
character. Yeah, look, see.
In this one, you go around as Sam O'Neill's character shooting dinosaurs as well. So yeah, so probably the same thing, but lower graphics. And guess what, that's coming in the future. Cool spot with the blue case. So the chances it's the blue case, it might be the Brazilian version, but hey, you never know. What was it, the mascot for 7-Up, weren't it? Was it 7-Up?
He's the dot.
He's the dot.
And just a platformer.
That's actually not a bad game on Mega Drive, which there's and stuff.
The only one I've actually played is, I think, Spot Goes to Hollywood. That's the only one I've spent time playing.
That's quite crap.
Yeah. So I played it, but I played the worst one.
It could be the same game.
Beagle.
Really good.
Terrible.
I really enjoy that.
Yes.
It's actually, I actually prefer this Beagle 2. This Beagle 2 is a bit more complicated. This is literally... throw the ball in the goal. It's literally throw the ball in the goal. Whereas 2 had multipliers and lots of really complicated mechanics, which I never got on with. I always preferred Speedball. That was on the Amiga. It's nice to have 2 buttons as well.
So. You always forget about the pad things. When I play on Master System games, I always play them by the power base. So I use the 6 button Mega Drive pad. And you just completely forget that when you go back to the Master System pad, you've got those little 2 buttons. Those little 2 buttons. Yeah. Getting better all day. The Lucky Diamond Caper featuring Donald Duck. This is another game that I have on the Game Gear and I didn't really like it, didn't think much of it. Sideways platformer.
It's like a lot of these, nearly all the Disney ones on the Master System aren't that great really, are they? They're pretty much classics on the Mega Drive and the NES, but they're not very good
for Master System. Huey, Dewey, and Louie?
Yes.
Yay! Yeah. and you're going to go rummaging through any gold. Now the next one, this is a strange one, because I looked and apparently it's in the top 10 Master System games of all time. Now I know jack shit about this, and it is Basketball Nightmare. I have no idea about this game whatsoever. It looks like you're just playing basketball. Okay, I'll read it out for you. You are the captain in the hometown high school's basketball team. You've won the tournament and are trying to win the All-American High School Championship. But then, one night, you had a very strange dream. And then it goes all into different foreign languages. So, does it mutate? Do they like... I don't know.
It just looks like a...
Yeah, we're not going to let you into what actually happens. I'm just happy for the sake of sticking on the menu. I mean, one of the top 10 games was a game called Buggy Heat or Buggy Dash or something like that. And they're crazy expensive. That's the most valuable one on the Master System. It's like 170. That's if you don't include the exclusive Brazilian launches like Street Fighter and things like that. There is no Dana. There is only Zul. I don't like this game at all. I didn't like it on Amiga. I found it too fast and unplayable.
It's a bad game.
It's a bad game.
That's a bad game. It was just that time of like lots and lots of Sonic and Mario ripoffs on the home computers and stuff.
I've seen that name for ages.
And they just never got it right. They never got it right. But it's like Western crap boy, which you expect. You know?
Ninja from the Nth Dimension.
Nth Dimension.
Nth Dimension. This game was quite fun. Sub-Breeze Tank. See, I'm playing at the moment on my phone, I'm always playing that Shark Evolved, Hungry Shark Evolved, and the girl eating up sharks. Whenever I see any games like this, I mean, I think it Echo the Dolphin with submarines and stuff like that. But, yeah, at the shop there's three copies of this, they're a rare game that's quite hard to find. And there's two more sat up there, both of them have manuals in. Where's the shop? Yeah. Mercs!
Is it 2 players?
On the Master System? No, it's 1 player. Yeah, love this game in the arcade. Top arcade in Deal, played it all the time. It's 3 player in the arcade. And always loved it. You always get up to the Harrier, but it was always near the boss of the second mission, which was the boat, weren't it? When you get up to the top and you have to go on the boat. You never get past that. But yeah, for what it was, I enjoyed playing it. Did you play much, Max?
It was alright. Yeah. The problem is, by the time it came out, it was kind of outdated. I mean... There were like, you know, Final Fight and various other bits and pieces were kind of out at that time, and I just no interest in Mercs at all really. It was just a bit of a throwback. You're kind of going back to sort of games like that, like Shock Trooping and stuff like that.
Yeah.
But at the time, I just had no interest in it. No interest at all.
The Master System version, I really want the Mega Drive version, but I got the Master System version. Apparently this is very different to the Mega Drive one. The Mega Drive one's based on the arcade. I could be completely wrong.
No, the Mega Drive's nothing like the arcade.
Oh, yeah, okay. So this is nothing like the arcade as well. But I'm looking forward to listening to some, or Tony will be, Michael Jackson tunes in Master System sound, which will be, because it's via the converter, will be the proper RF. FM sound. Oh, that's what I'm telling you, isn't it? So, a bit Michael Jackson. Not played this one, but just Michael Jackson. Drastically underpriced purchase from PlayNation Games, and that's Dr. Robot from the Moonbeam Machine. Payu Payu with Dr. Robot.
Pew Pew is a science bad. If you can get like the Mega Drive or Super Nintendo Japanese versions of Pew Pew, get those. They have so much more personality with the weird voices and stuff when you're kind of doing stuff. It's just bonkers. It's awesome.
It's awesome sauce. Champions of Europe. Yay, top down football. Very, I'd say, Sabutio.
Kick off. Very kick off.
Very kick off.
Not as good. Nowhere near as good.
No, but you can go all over the world. It's the official game of UEFA 92, apparently. Oh, yeah, and they've got a big bunny playing for football on the front. So, yay. A game that I'm really looking forward to playing, and that is Sagaia. It's.
Darius!
Basically Darius and so similar to R-Type. Once again, I wanted to play it, but I haven't played it. But it came out on Genesis, didn't it? It came out in Japan and America, but I don't think it came out over here. So have you played this?
It's alright. Yeah. It's Darius. Yeah.
Darius.
It's a cut down 8-bit Darius. It's still pretty cool.
Lemmings.
Miss Lemmings. Better than Mouse. Better than me than Mouse.
Really. Yeah. Get your Lemmings from the start to the goal. Try not to kill too many on the way. Dig many holes.
It was amazing when it came out. It really was amazing when it came out. But
remember the weekend Mark got it on the Amiga. All weekend we were playing it. Fantastic.
And then they brought out 3D Lemmings on the PlayStation, weren't it?
I'm not entirely
3D Lemmings?
Yeah, and that was
fucking awful.
It was,
I can't imagine that working.
It was hard and difficult, but it was a bit like Marmite. You were either going to love it or you were going to hate it.
It took a really simple formula and just fucked it up.
Yeah. I had Marmite. Super Monaco Grand Prix.
The first one.
But Ayrton Senna's not in this one.
And it's top down as well.
Yeah.
No, it's not.
It's
it should
high.
Be.
Yeah. But apparently it's not.
Oh, because Super Monaco Grand Prix. Monaco Grand Prix is the one that's top down. And then Super Monaco Grand Prix.
Yeah. I've always liked these games, but I could never get the corners right. It's just so...
Well, you just can't drive. We know. There's,
I drive a real car, just not in computer games.
The Terminator.
Walking ahead. Yeah, the Terminator in the Master System. You play as Kyle Reese on the future. Lone Warrior.
Every version of the Terminator is horrible in different ways.
Yeah. Probably pretty much the Game Gear version, but the Game Gear version of that as well.
E-Swap!
It was cheap. Known as the notoriously worst version ever created and notoriously hard and bad to play.
Moving on.
That's about run. There's 3 more copies of this up at that shop, by the way, just to really rub it in. Outrun, but apparently you battled you. You accelerate into a coast-to-coast test of stamina, wits and coordination in the heart-pounding sequel to Outrun and chase down and capture 8 of the fastest, nastiest syndicate bosses on wheels. Strap yourself in and grab hold of the wheel and get ready to smash, crush and bash away to the glory. So Chase HQ.
What do you actually read the back?
So basically they've turned
Outrun
into Chase HQ.
Yeah, it's exactly what it is. It's just basically Chase HQ.
Cloudmaster.
It's basically Cloudmaster, really cool, sideways scrolling sort of shooting up thing. Version's the best one.
Yeah, really good game. A very, very super uncommon in America, and games that love this is like their top game, so it's really worth playing if they like it. Might be a quickie. Shoot through my Mega Drive ones. You've got to get to the end of the day somehow. Jurassic Park on the Mega Drive. Jurassic Park on the Mega Drive. To go with the Master System version, the Mega Drive version, much better. Very strange because you play as Sam Neill's character. I can't remember who you play, but you go around with guns and you shoot dinosaurs and stuff, which is
completely the antithesis, the opposite of what his character would do. Yeah.
There's also like Jurassic Park Rampage Edition. I don't know what's different in that one, but this is what I got. Stargate, just because it's ridiculously cheap. Battle. Raft, the control of the. I've watched the film, I know nothing about the TV series. But you try the
series?
Series.
For sure?
Yeah. You travel through time to the Stargate and you do stuff. This looks like. What the fuck does that look like?
It looks like a flashback.
So. Green. Because I don't actually own a single version of this, NBA Jam. Which is quite odd because I thought I did, but I don't.
Score 3 times and your ball will catch on fire.
Oh yeah, of course. I can't even think about that. NBA Jam. I also have the Saturn version, apparently. God, I keep forgetting because I remember
Chicago Bulls.
2 of them on the Saturn as well, isn't it? Mm-hmm. Yeah. I love this game. Never played this. I always played this back in the day on Peter Ingalls' Wild Card. Me and Jason had much fun playing on that thing where he used to just...
Good job you never played me. I would kick your asses.
You always cheat, you know.
That'd have been Chicago Bulls, Pippen and Jordan.
Yes.
Get them on fire and go outside the 3 points.
It's a game that you would need the instructions for. It was like a sort of space kind of thing.
The thing is, I was at Stewart's and I sort of like. So getting this from the space there, that was spoiling on the Mega Drive. Basically, the guy where I got this from, so I've never heard of it. Like, I'll shoot it, I'll scan it, and look at the eBay prices and stuff like that. I could get it at Markham at $9.50. But they've got less than half of that. And when I saw the prices on me, once again, this is like a £50 game. And then I looked on IGN for their reviews, and they've got like 9, 9, 5. And so, I was confused because it had Electronic Arts in the box as well.
Yeah, yeah.
And the shooter in Electronic Arts back in the day.
What a good game, Electronic Arts back in the day.
Yeah.
It wasn't sports.
Yeah, so you got.
Yeah, that's it. It wasn't right. Sport.
Well, there was basically there was like Desert Strike, and that was it.
The strikes.
They're all. Yeah, Road Rash come along. They didn't redeem themselves.
This is what I'm really looking forward to playing. Actually, for a good 2-player game, and you're orange and blue, so maybe you won't get too confused this time. Cheaper one on the site is Double Dragon 3. And that's not a very good game. Yeah, no, it's not a very good game, but it's going to be Bimmy and Jimmy. Oh my god. No.
It was on the NES translation. Yeah. They had Bimmy. Billy and Bimmy.
Yeah, I mean, I know this isn't any good in any way, shape, or form, but to have it for the collection, that looks crap. Crackdown! Pick this up once again from Regenerating Gaming in Norwich.
Fun game. It's really
Ben weird. And Andy, the two super sets.
It's kind of like what would happen if you turned the original Metal Gear on the NES into a shooter. It's kind of like that. That's strange.
Cool.
Very
cool.
A bit Gauntlet-esque.
One player murked on the Mega Drive, so everything was said for the Master System on the Mega Drive, but with better graphics.
Yeah.
But still
it one looks player. Nice, it looked really nice, but one player was a point. Yeah.
Still one player, I mean the point for Merc was co-op.
That comes from second hand then.
Yeah. Yes. Dragon's Revenge. Yeah.
This is not based on the PC Engine. It was an unofficial sequel made by Tengen or whatever it was.
Tengen, yeah.
And it sucks balls.
They were developing at Unit 5, Sirico Close, Moulton Park, Northampton, NN3, 1MP in the UK. So, pinball, and that's where it goes a lot. Finally, my last pickup of the month. That is Rock and Roll Racing. Yeah, so basically.
Tarquin is about to blow!
When I picked this up, I said to Tony, is it any good? I remember playing the SNES version back in the day, but then the Mega Drive version was very good.
The SNES version is definitely better, but it's still a good game.
Yeah.
That's RC Pro and the Gun, which is what I basically said to him. Was, I'm having that then! Because he was RC Pro and the
But yeah, so all good. That's my pickups for the month, guys. Take care, and we'll see you soon.
People say online.
People shit on a piece of hot buttered toast online. Does not mean I want to.
Don't fancy toast anymore today. That's for
exactly
sure.
Yeah. So
where the hell did you see that? Coming around here.